John. Thank you.
Bene, bene, molto bene. Can't blame it on the moon no more, no. Can't blame it on the radar weather. Can't blame it on my lucky stars, my mother and my father. I'm holed up in the bell tower, looking for four walls to bounce off. Looking for a donkey I can maybe pin a tail on, yeah. Taking a stand up late, taking up bowling. I take a couple aspirin and I call my lover in the morning. And I'm taking a talking to myself, I don't even get it. I gotta get out of my head, it'll drive me crazy if I let it. Who holds? Yeah, yeah. When you're alone, who holds your hand? On and I looked at Rand McNally and I put a couple of shoes on and I hurried down the alley and I'm driving down the highway trying to get the lead out, rolling down the window, I'm sticking my neck out. Who holds? Yeah. When you're alone, who holds your hand? Real good. Some people believe in God like they believe in knocking on wood. Religion is a picture window. Life is not a pretty picture. Battles when the wind blows. I never knew what hit her. Oh, when you're
see you. So much art has been, I mean, you have to be fairly wealthy to look this distressed, I think, at this point, but this is a very valuable property because of 20 summers. Because of the people who painted here, came here, danced here, and apparently got nude here, but I want to hear more about that. I need to think about it.
Take your days, I
Take your darkest days, take your days, take your dark days, and inside your painting, there I'll be, inside your painting. I'm cadmium yellow, I'm walking across the green. I take your days. And I'm fond of your fantasies. The sky is vermilion, the sun is sienna, another chartreuse day. The landscape is shimmering outside. Take your days, I take your darkest days, I take your days, I take your dark days, and inside your painting is a blue trapeze. Inside your painting, you're playing harmonica, I'm reading erotica.
This show, it's a one-shot show, is called Down Through the Wood. And I was talking to Josh beforehand, and he said, well, what's the concept? I said, well, the concept is to select songs that have no angst in them. That, and then also somehow touched or referenced nature. So that was that. It's kind of like playing Valentine's Day and getting all those terrible love songs out of the set list. It's a good exercise. No. Okay, yeah, I get that. But I don't know, you know, I'm just so stressed out. You know, I'm thinking of taking a stress test some point soon, and I don't know why, because I live in a town of 3,000 people year-round. And it's getting a little busier now, but still, I play guitar all day. I mean, how stressful can that be? I don't get it. But I've kind of been stressed out all my life. It works for me, I guess. I mean, like first grade, I was so stressed out about first grade. I don't know about you, but I mean, the alphabet? Nobody told me about the alphabet. It was so stressful. I was like, oh yeah, so much, I got it. You know, well, who needs to learn that? And so I didn't. And you would have thought my parents would have given a heads up. These will come in handy later in life. The A, B, C, go beyond that. Go beyond your initials and just explore. So I nearly flunked first grade, which was so stressful. It's hard to flunk first grade, too, because they're nice to you, supposedly. But anyway, and then the following year, I got completely stressed out at First Communion, right? The dress, the book, the memorization, the purse, I don't know. It was the 50s. You know, so I had to decide to become a Catholic at 7. And that's stressful. That's a big decision, you know? So I've started meditating, and my friend, our friend Kristen says, you know, I've whittled it down now. She says 5 minutes is okay. She said, you have 5 minutes, don't you? I said, I think so. I'm not sure at all, but I have found 5 minutes first thing in the morning. I go down the deck and I drink some tea, and then I close my eyes for 5 minutes and just listen to the birds. And it's a little bit stressful because I'm worried about analyzing, you know, the bird sounds and identifying them, but I'm trying to let that go. So I was doing that the other morning. Let me tune. I was out on the deck. I had done my little meditation. I was completely relaxed and watching birds. And it was really fun because a bird was actually using the bird bath, which always makes you feel good, right? Because they're picky. They're very picky. And I hadn't cleaned it properly, so I was so happy. So anyway, I'm sitting there, and all of a sudden, this huge hawk swoops into the yard right near the bird bath, grabs a chipmunk in its talons, and flies away. I mean, that was so stressful. It's kind of like the Wizard of Oz, but in my backyard. So now I'm going to take up yoga. It's been on my to-do list for decades. And I just never wanted to take the edge off before, and now I do.
We are surrounded by so much water that we might as well get a boat. We could swim like Neptune's daughter to the other side of the moat. Coming up for air. Rising to a very new somewhere. Coming up for air. On the last breath around. We are sleeping in a canyon where the walls rise up to the sky. We could reach the rim by standing and begin to breathe with a sigh. Coming up for air. Rising to a very new. Where coming up for air. Last breath around. We are sway like a willow that is. We could wave goodbye and fly into the hills and into the blue. Coming up for air. Rising to a very where coming up for air on the last breath around, the last breath around. The last breath around.
Take a Stratocaster to the dunes.
Thank you.
in preparation. Now I've been given this gift of a dune shack. No other way to describe it. Sitting with my daughters, Ruby and Shadan. Their other mother. As the light begins to fade. 2 hours of sunlight left. By the Lori Allman sunlight methods. Basically, put your face under, fist under the sun, measure, measure, measure. Each fist is an hour. Just thought I'd explain that. I didn't write that in the journal, because I already know. I look west and dunes and sun. What I'd be doing at home.
Could be worse. They say it will not hurt. This day is the first. It's like no other.
Yeah.
all of the hours lost in sand dollar towers when you turn your face to mine. The days are long, nothing can go wrong. Life is but a song, my nature lover.
One of the first things that I wrote out in the dunes, and it became sort of the theme song for the week. Of course, it's not a lot of competition on the top 10 for that slot, but and my daughters wrote songs and poems and journaling, so I won't ask them to come up and do that. But first times we went out there, stayed for the week with the girls, it was May. It was still school going on. So we made them get up every day, except one, I think, and pack their bikes and pack a little lunch and hike out over the dunes to Truro Central School. On time. And I stayed and I wrote all day, but it's a pretty long hike from the dune shacks out to Route 6 on Snail Road, if you know, and I would just wait until I hear way, way off in the distance, way on top of that bowl that's right before, you can see the sea and you can see the bay at the same exact time, so it's very, very high. I hear, I go running out with a guitar on and an apron and end of the day. Same exact thing would happen, but in reverse. I go running out this path that we had memorized by this time. Breadcrumbs, something. running through the wood, catch up with them. We'd start our day for real. Down through the wood, I go tramping in with my crust of bread and my tea again. With all this time, hear the road, tires fade to black, and my footsteps know I'm not coming back. With all this time. Down through the wood, I go tramping in till my skin feels good on my bones again. With all this time. This time. Thanks. Very kind. You live a life in a day out there, for sure. Sometimes that's good, and sometimes it's just a really good lesson, how long the day is. Well, I didn't write this in the dunes, but I sure played it a lot that week. We had a huge storm that came up. Big thunder and lightning storm. Marla and, yeah, Liz, remember? I wrote a song called We Went Running Out, because that's what they did. But I was not ready for prime time yet. But it was a huge, huge storm. And the amazing thing is that, of course, you can see these things coming for miles and miles away. And you can hear them. And then you're in them. So we did this one night as the thunder and lightning just rang through the dune shack. And Xiao, you were asleep, but Ruby was awake. We got to the choruses, we just screamed it. It's a poem by Kay Ryan that I set to music called Green Behind the Ears. I was still slightly fuzzy in shady spots, and the tenderest line, it was lovely as I look back, but not at the time. For it's hard to be green and take your turn. Hard to be green and take your turn. Hard to be green and take your turn. It's flesh. So much freshness to unlearn. So much freshness to unlearn. So much freshness to unlearn. Spots and the tenderest line, it was lovely as I look back, but not at the time. For it's hard to be green and take your turn. Hard to be green and take your turn. Hard to be green and take your turn. Flesh. So much freshness to unlearn. 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 But it went on for another 30 minutes. what's really fun about the dune shacks too is unless you bring a bag of books, there's not a lot to read. If you finished your book, or you're taking a break from your book, so you end up reading the journal, and then that's done, and then you end up reading a lot of nature books, and so you actually get an education about things you don't know about. So, I reference that in this next song. Let's see. This is the one that I haven't sung in front of an audience. I guess is what I'm trying to say. Before, except for the birds, I bet. Distractions. It's actually a beautiful thing. You've got to walk a long way from any distractions.
I make a fire against the chill. One to stop me, I'm alone. I find myself at the windowsill, calling it home. I'm learning the names for all the things that disappear and you cannot hold. That I could fly on wings, calling it home, calling it home, calling it home. A 100 years ago, they say, China came, the salt spray rose. My rose of China found her way, calling it home, calling it home, calling it home. Oh. And if you say you cannot think, with that thought, there is no worry. I've been standing on the break. Now I'm in no hurry. I sip a cup of tea, a cup of tea to warm my soul. And if you come, remember me, calling it home, calling it home, calling it home. Oh. Oh. night and live the life of ease. Hand in hand and side by side, we'd each do as we please. I have a rock in my backyard that sits beneath the tree. I climb its back, it's warm and hard, and I can feel the breeze. Wait till the honeymoon's over, believe me, I believe you'll never leave me. I the afternoon along a windowsill, I chased it down in an old red cart, and I'm looking for it still. We live our life by the old walk in the tall grass by the sea. Long amber light, your lips unlock. This is where I want to be.
New York is far away from here. New York is far away from here. You can see it in the rain. You can see it in the cheap suits and the ties. It's just a falling away frontier. It's just a falling away frontier. And they are fancied with fast food chains and buildings that go up before your eyes. You say everybody's marching to the same beat, marching to the same beat of the drum. Everybody's thinking about the same thing, but I will beg to differ with you. New York is far away from here. New York is far away from here. See it in the car.
coffee shops and catch it from the corner of your eye. Just a layer of thin veneer. It's just a layer of thin veneer. And it stretches like a parking lot. It's swept up in a string of satellites. You say everybody's marching to the same beat, to the same beat of the drum. Everybody's thinking about the same thing, but I will beg to differ with you. Full moon rising on Indiana night, freight train coming through, two kids riding on one bike, and I think about my love and pull my sweater a little tighter, and I look off in the distance, I feel a little better, and you say, everybody's marching to the same beat. Yeah, marching to the same beat of the drum. Everybody's thinking about the same thing. I will beg to differ. New York is far away from here. And you can see it in the setting sun. See it just before you say goodbye. It's just a landscape of souvenirs. It's all a landscape of souvenirs. Yeah, I'm embarrassed to be human. I'm embarrassed that I want what I despise. You see, everybody's marching to the same beat. The same beat of the drum. Everybody's thinking about the same thing.
I have some feelings about that. Yeah, well, anyway. Heard enough, and I've seen enough, and I know enough to know. I know a good thing when I see it, and it's a bad thing to let go. Well, I've been around, I've been up. Your world all in motion. Gotta put a ball and a chain on your soul. All those angels running, picking up the pieces and putting back together hearts broke long ago. I know a good thing when I see it. Thank you.
there will always be lovers with borders of their own, and you may charge across in a golden chariot, but you will never be your own. And I had dreams like distant thunder, and I had hope like a prayer unheard. But this is nothing less than perfect in a less than perfect world. All those angels running, picking up the pieces, putting back together hearts broke long ago. I know a good thing when I see it, it's a bad thing to let go.
More for you here, and I think one of the good things that, just to plug this place and what Josh has done and the people who work here and volunteer here is basically save a national treasure. So let's give them a big round of applause for doing that kind of work. I've been trying to describe these windows, and they're huge. They're bigger than I thought they were. They're the size of your shirt. No, they're not. No, they're bigger than that. But they do remind me of our friend River's place out on Bonbrook Island. It had windows maybe a third smaller than that, but an old ice house. And she was famous around these parts for skateboarding down Route 6, things like that. So I wrote this about her. River let her dog run free from the bay to where the island used to be. That dog was the only thing she called baby. Down a dirt road she would follow in a half-remembered dream. See, this is one thing that could save. They ran in between shadows of green. I have to start this again. I don't sing this very often, apparently. Hold on. Just keeping the dream, keeping the dream, keeping the dream alive. I'm in the right tuning. Tried. Ah, jeez. I know, cut. out there. Well, let me tell you about Sweetie. Since we got time. Sweetie's the dog I'm referring to, and I wrote this while watching Sweetie in a photograph. Sweetie was so very, very fast. She was an Irish setter, and she was a little high-strung. Just a little high-strung, yes, yes. Adorably high-strung dog. So the photograph is something that River took from her mountain bike that she was riding in the dunes, okay? That gives you another idea of her athleticism. So she's got this really cool camera, and she's taking a picture of her dog running faster than she is while she's riding and taking the photograph, and the dog just looks like... There's a big blur with a big red tongue that's about that long. It's a little wound up dog. Anyway. River let her dog run free from the bay to where the island used to be. That dog was the only thing she called baby. Down a dirt road, she would follow in a half-remembered dream, saying, this is the one thing that could save me. They ran in between shadows of green, on gossamer wings while the sunset rained. River let her dog run free from the bay to where the island used to be. She moved through the grass like she was praying. And the wind rose in the hollows and kissed her silently. She said, only the wind knows what I'm saying. Let a dog run free from the bay to where the island used to be. That dog was the only thing she called baby. She said the cold goes to my very soul deep beneath the skin. Leaving is the one thing that can save me. Shadows of green, gossamer wings while the sunset brightly. Yeah. For coming here tonight, listen to my story songs. All right, well, been a lot of fun. Thank you so much for inviting me here and just joining me. Josh, thank you for inviting me, and you guys, thanks for coming here, and you look so good. Besides, and you showed up on time, and you climbed that mountain. And ain't no mountain high enough. But it's easier going down, I hear, so. All right. One thing, when we first moved here, Bette and I, didn't seem like there were that many musicians here. I mean, they were all hiding, you know, in sand dunes and things like that, I suppose, but always painters and writers, and the pleasurable thing is that more and more people are using, you know, the World Wide Web, so they can live down here. It's really great. But I've always been inspired by writers and artists, painters. This is about all the books I love and the book I'm not reading right now, which is it's a book for everyone called Wonder, recommended by my children. If you go on my Facebook page, someone has written a short story to one of my songs and challenged me to do the same with someone else's song, so that's kind of fun. There's a connect. There's a link to this song that has nothing to do with nature. The book I'm not reading is riveting. The book I'm not reading keeps me up at night. The book I'm not reading is better than TV, giving me insight. The book I'm not reading is history. The book I'm not reading by some paperback writer. The book I'm not reading is a mystery. Who done it don't matter. Oh, I need someone to read me stories. Oh, someone to turn the page. We just had the one. Let's try it. Oh, I need someone to read me stories. No lyrics required. Oh, someone to turn the page. Oh, the endless quest for love and glory. Oh, does not fade away. The book I'm not reading is an ancient tome. The book I'm not reading was born yesterday. The book I'm not reading keeps me off the phone with nothing to say. The book I'm not reading is a self-help kind. The book I'm not reading has a life jacket enclosed. The book I'm not reading is a friend of mine. God knows we need those. Oh, I need someone to read me stories. Oh, someone to turn the page. For love and glory. Oh, yeah. Let's not fade away with it.
book I'm not reading is on the internet. The book I'm not reading is a brand new movie. The book I'm not reading isn't out yet. It's all new to me. The book I'm not reading is not written down. The book I'm not reading is an English translation. The book I'm not reading should be read aloud. Impatient. Oh, I need someone to read me stories. Oh, someone to turn the page. The endless quest for love and glory. Oh, does not fade away.
Signing CDs. I have Still Green, which is the songs of the Dunes and others, my latest studio release, and also 25 love songs that I played on acoustic guitar and sang, and then asked 25 of my dearest musician friends to join me, people like Cheryl Wheeler and Greg Brown and John Gorka and Mary Chapin Carpenter, Sean Colvin, who will be here next week at the PAM. Is that sold out? We don't know. Yes. No, 2 weeks, the 27th. Yeah, I'm ahead of myself. Anyway, that's available. But especially tonight, I made a special fundraiser for the Peaked Hill Trust, which they are the group, one of the groups that manage 5 to 7 dune shacks. It varies on the wind and the sand. But I just love them so much. And there's a 3-song CD available for $5. Are they here tonight? Did they show up or no?
Yes.
Oh, okay. So whatever they want to charge, you have to pay them for this. And it's 3 songs from Still Green. Whatever you want to charge. $80 tonight only. Thank you so much. It's an honor playing here. Please remember me when the moon is high. Please remember me standing by the water's side. And when you talk of forget-me-nots in Orion's Thanks so much. God bless. Have a wonderful, wonderful time tonight.